Well, hello and welcome to Producer Dan. Thanks for stopping by the channel today. So as promised in my last video, I'm going to talk about some of the plugins that come with Pro Tools and also the M-Audio Oxygen Pro 49, which I just purchased. And I did a video on this, on how to set it up and how to use it in Pro Tools, my last video, so check that one out. So today we're talking about Xpand 2. If I were stranded on a desert island and can only have one plugin, one virtual instrument to use, I would choose this. This comes in Pro Tools. It was introduced back in 2008 as part of the Air virtual instruments package that they included with Pro Tools back then. So it's not new. If you have Pro Tools, you have this this virtual instrument, this plugin, and chances are you use it. I use it in all of my productions, whether I'm putting down strings and orchestration or a bass line or a synth bass line. It has piano, it has different types of acoustic piano or electric piano, organs, synthesizer sounds, exotic instrument sounds. You can put together whole drum kits with this plugin. It's multi-timbral, which means you can layer the sounds, or you can use the separate MIDI channels and just use it as a workstation and send MIDI to each different channel that way. And you can mix the level, the pan. It has two effects sends. You can control the effects, take them off. I'm going to explore Xpand today. I'm going to take you through everything that it does. So here we go. All right, so here we are looking at the Xpand plugin. And you can see at the top here, I have put some MIDI down, and this is a natural grand piano sound. Okay, and that's under the acoustic piano folder. And if we look at that, there are many choices here. I'll play a different one for you. This is called Edge Piano. This has kind of a nice ambiance. And as we look at all of the choices, we have the soft pads, the bright pads, action pads. Those are very interesting. Layered pads, percussive instruments. This thing is vast. So if I have one complaint about the plugin, it's that it has too many sounds to go through, too many sounds to audition. So I wondered, is there a setting or some kind of feature that will play me a little bit of each one and move on to the next one? And there is. If you go here to this folder and click this button, you'll see right now we're in the soft pads folder, and you can see it has 68 different choices. And that would take a long time to click, you know, and go through, play it, click and go through, play it. So down here at the bottom, it says increment settings every 1 second. I recommend changing that to 5 seconds. So it'll start at the first one. Next one. So you get the idea. It will go through each one of those, and you don't have to keep reaching to click on to the next one. So when I found that feature, I was very, very happy with that, because I was always going through these little arrows to move on to the next one, which they're very small, and it doesn't always register. You have to get really exact with that. So another way to do that is through this drop-down menu. This is just a little easier to see, and maybe a little easier to navigate than this one. See, that's a little smaller. So let's move on to these different sections of the plugin. Starting here, because this is what we really want to concentrate on, here are the different patch areas. There's four. And these, you can stack different sounds. So this is a blend of a female ah vocal with a digital brass sound. And right now, you can see the brass is turned off. This is the on and off button. Here's what it sounds like by itself. And if I turn on the digital brass, and you can change the level of each sound. See, I've turned down the female choir sound. Also, you can pan the different sounds. Not only can you change the levels, but you can, let's say I wanted to put the female choir on the left and the brass on the right. Okay. And here are the effects sends, effects 1 and 2, and each patch section has their own sends. So you can see that the female choir sound has a lot of effects on it. Looks like it's a reverb and a delay. So not only do you have the option of turning each effect up and down, but you also have the option of turning them on and off and using the effects that you've already loaded in your DAW. So just know that you have that option as well. Not only that, but you can also, with these smart knobs on the top, you can go in and change the attack and the decay and the release of all the different sounds. I'll give you an example of this. I'm going to turn off the female vocals and we're just going to go with this sound here. I'll move that over to the middle again. Okay, so I want to change the attack for the B section of the workstation. So I'll click on that and you can change all of these parameters here. So here's the attack. You can take the attack really fast or kind of slow it down so it opens like that. And the same thing can be done on the release. So here I have the release set really fast, so it stops really fast, or I can change that to make it kind of release slowly. So depending on the sound, it will have its different parameters up here that can be controlled, and you toggle through A, B, C, D by using these buttons here. All right, so if we look down here at the effects, effects 1 and 2, and if we look at the drop-down menu, you can see we have all these choices of different reverbs, delays, flangers, choruses. All of these effects are here, and those are on both sides, effects 1 and effects 2. And you can also see, depending on the effect you have chosen, you'll have control over these parameters as well, depending on the effect that you have chosen. So, as far as control, you have a lot of control of the effects, the panning, the stacking of the different patches for this plugin. And not only that, you have just a vast number of different sounds. So this is really the best example I have for you as far as how I use Xpand. You can see I have it on each one of these tracks. This is an orchestration setup that I did for a song called Crystal Clear by my friend Vicky Andres, and I put this orchestration in the background of the lead solo. And you can see I have different strings set up here. Everything from here to here in this brown color is a different string set up through Xpand, different string sound. And then I have some brass sounds here. I have trumpets, orchestra brass, and a French horn. And then I have a tuba and some flutes. So I'll play this for you. Again, it's my best example on how I love to use Xpand. Okay, so I hope this gave you a better understanding of the plugin Xpand 2. Again, it is my favorite plugin. I believe it's the most useful one that I have. I use it all the time. If you have Pro Tools, you have this in your arsenal, so I'm sure you are using it. And if you are, I hope this video gave you a better understanding of the plugin. So thank you so much for watching the video. If you like the video, please like and subscribe to the channel if you haven't. And I look forward to seeing you in my next video. Take care.